A 53rd GST Council meeting that is scheduled for June 22nd, and that is the next key trigger that stock markets are awaiting. Business Today Television was the first to bring you this exclusive update that the central government is considering quashing retrospective tax for the Indian online gaming industry. And now this is something that our correspondent Karishma Asudani has been tracking very, very closely as well. Karishma, welcome to the show. And do tell us, does this look like a big sign of relief for the entire online gaming companies? And of course, many of them are also listed on the stock markets.
Yes, Sakshi, definitely is going to be a sigh of relief for them, knowing the fact that they've been looking for some kind of cushioning that from the government, especially since the fact that government has imposed a 28% tax. Now, to explain our viewers what exactly is expected and the important documents that we access talk about insertion of a Section 11A under the CGST Act, which already exists under the Indian law. In fact, it is implied also to excise as of now. As per this Section 11A, government will have the power to do away with unpaid or underpaid taxes, levies. Like, for example, if there is an online gaming firm who has not paid their tax until now, then this power, if implemented, will give the government a chance to give them a green light and to do away with the tax. But for those who have already made taxes, irrespective overpaid taxes, will not be refunded. Now, this will be great for the smaller online gaming firms who have complained that it's been a bloodbath for them, especially after the 28% tax. It also somewhere in a way legitimizes the whole industry and gives online gaming firms a chance to not put themselves into dispute with the government going forward. A decision on this will only be taken by the council in the June 22nd meeting, but this recommendation coming from the law committee is very, very important at this juncture, where most of the state finance ministers in the past couple of months have asked government to do away with the DGGI show cause notices of close to 2 lakh crore. And this will give them the power to do away with it.
Okay, but what else could be on the agenda this time around on June 22nd? That's the biggest meeting that we are looking at from markets perspective also, Karishma.
Yes, Sakshi. In fact, I noted down a couple of important recommendations that have come in, which likely will be approved by the council. The new government, the new state finance minister, mostly who will be joining, they'll be looking at doing away with the GST on aerated drinks. Now, current is 28%, so this could go to zero. There could be a blanket exemption for fertilizers. Currently, it's about 5%. There could be rate reductions for aircraft parts, for solar cookers, for carton boxes from about 18 to 12%. For solar, it could go from 18 to 5%. For aircraft, 18 to 5%. But for carton boxes, for apples, it could go from 18 to 12%. This was a special request by the Jammu and Kashmir Finance Minister team and was also well studied by the Fitmin committee in their previous few meetings. What did not really come on the agenda is, I will address the elephant in the room, and that is fuel being under the ambit of GST, which in fact Oil Minister Hardeep Singh Puri had also shared a couple of weeks back, especially when the new government was formed, that he would like the council to consider this, but that was completely not discussed by Fitmin committee. So it's very unlikely that it could come in the council discussion.
All right. Thanks a lot, Karishma, for all those details. And we'll continue to get more details on the upcoming meeting from you in the coming days as well.